I guess it right here.
Something is still wrong. It's not going in there. All right, stop, live. I just refreshed in there. All right, if anyone out there can hear or see anything on this live stream right now, could you text me? You have my number? Or type in the chat room? And do I want to put this mic on? It's on. Screen share. Google Hangouts would like to share the content to your screen with Plus Google. Google Plus Hangouts. Just this. Wants to share that. I don't want to share that. I can share the entire screen. I can share
just sharing your computer screen. You just want the video, so just click here.
But it's not sharing. It's telling me it wants to share it. It's not sharing it right now. Let me just try the share. No, it didn't work. All right. Yes. All right. We are live. Now this is how you do. All right. So everybody, this is our first time with this technology, and I have to hold this. Okay. So I would just love a quick little test here. I think Richard O'Brien's out there. He has my cell. He can text me. Richard, please let me know. All right, there. Ask you this, we're talking, but they'll be quiet when Dr. Templeman starts. What I want to know is from right here, if I just leave the mic there, can you hear this well on air? Okay, mute out the phone. Sorry, we've got a lot of people tuning into this. Okay.
Because you're a star.
Yes, you are. I'm going back to Thailand soon. My internet connection is terrible. Is it? All right. Are you listening to me on air? Okay, I'm going to mute my phone. Hang on. All right, just one last test. I just want to know from right here with that mic over there, not holding it in my hand, am I loud and clear? Answer? Is that good? Perfect. Thank you so much. All right, we're going to get started here in just 1 second. Thanks, Lily. Okay, bye. All right, everyone. We're so excited. This is our first time to do an on-air broadcast, so we can start doing these. We do weekly opportunity meetings in our home pretty much every single week, and lately since launch of AERIS, it's been three times a week, so it's been kind of exciting. So we thought today, since we had such a special guest, Dr. Frederick Templeman, in the house, the world's leading authority on the mangosteen fruit, as well as a 20-year practicing physician, both the United States and Canada board certified. So pretty special to have him here. So we thought we should keep him just to our Utah selves. So we thought we'd share a little bit of Dr. Templeman with everybody else. So I think everybody can see and hear great. That's awesome. I'm going to give a quick little business overview of the XANGO opportunity, simply because a lot of people, we have a lot of guests that are tuning in here, a lot of guests here in the room. I want to thank you guys all for coming. I'm going to give you a short little business overview so that we can go into a longer product training, which we normally do here. But so thank you for your time. And I want to talk to you a little bit about this company behind this brand new product line. XANGO is a 13-year-old network marketing company which has accomplished some amazing things over the years. So we happen to beat a lot of records, and we're the fastest company to do 100 million and 250 million a year in sales. By the way, 36 companies only have ever done in sales. And you know that less than 50 companies have ever made it to their 10th birthday. So I want you to know that really there's been tens of thousands of documented companies since the 1950s. That really reflects probably hundreds of thousands of companies, because most of them come and go before they ever even file their first corporate tax return or even get on the books for the records to even have a statistic. But I want you to know that this company is very special because they launched with this beverage called XANGO juice, and I know Dr. Templeman's going to talk a little bit about it, because the mangosteen has been proven to be the single most important botanical that's ever been discovered. It has more health benefits than any other botanical, and because of that, you'll find that it is the common denominator in every one of our products. And one of the best things that the mangosteen does is for the skin, so it's certainly in our anti-aging cosmeceutical lines. But we've done $1 billion for the sales with this one product, and you'll see lots of different bottles because we just have fun like that. And we come out with different bottles and different themes and just share the same love with everybody. And it's been really, really fun. Our 11th year, we got a patent on that product. And of course, our goal is to become the fastest company to ever do $1 billion a year in sales. And I think we'll do it because the current record holder, 18 years, and we are well on our way to beat that record as well. So let's just look at some stuff. This is some of the product lines that XANGO offers. We started with that juice the first 5 years, but then we started to expand. We've got a lot of great products in here. I'm not going to talk to you about all of these products tonight, I promise. But I'm going to talk to you about just a couple of them, because I want you to know kind of what's been happening the last couple of years. We launched this Limitless product about 2 years ago, and a lot of our younger generation started marketing it as a healthy alternative to energy drinks. And that's because they're the largest consumer of that market. And so by being able to drink something that's very healthy, and simply by educating people that this is the alternative, this is what's out there. If you want an energy drink, you are getting hundreds and hundreds of calories. You got to learn to be a label reader, because, for example, a 32-ounce can of Monster has 4 servings. So it might say 100 calories, but that's per serving, 4 servings per can. It's 400 and over 108 grams of sugar. And of course, that is the deadliest thing that we can do to our bodies today is sugar. I mean, Dr. Temple, I'm sure, will reference that. But we just have to educate people and tell them there's a healthier alternative. And because of this product line, this younger generation, the business has been as simple as drinking and sharing the products with others. They started a movement called MB30. Now, it stands for Millionaire by 30 or Mentoring by 30. And it doesn't even matter if it's by 30, but the fact of the matter is this generation is finally in a place where younger generations have never been hurting like they are today. In the past, they could go out and conquer the world as soon as they turned 18 years old and got out of school. And today, even after a 4-year college degree, if they're able to do that, they have to. The average millennial goes back home to live with mom and dad for 2 years before they're able to get a job to support themselves. So that's the world that we live in today. We offer solutions to that financially and in products. We actually have a couple of other products we came out with, Ignite and Reload. Actually originally developed as pre and post workout products because the Ignite's a vasodilator, gets the heart pumping. We all need that though every day. It's good for our cardiovascular health. So we all drink this product. And our Reload, which is an anti-aging product because it helps rebuild the muscles, and helps rehydrate the cells. So post-workout product is great, but right before bed, we'll wake up feeling fantastic the next day. And we market it with trying your best day yet. So for all of our brand new guests here today, I have, they're back there, and Corbin, I will let you hand those out to people. Everybody put your hand up, and we will give you a free sample of your best day yet. And those of you who invited these guests, make sure that you plug them into your My XANGO Builder and your Get Amped app. And that way, tomorrow morning, you will be so impressed. You'll get a text in the morning reminding you to take your Ignite. It comes from the app. But, you know, you'll be impressed that, wow, they followed up with me. We have a lot of great tools to help us with stuff like that. And we have systems around it. We have these packs that you can get these products in the containers like you're looking at right now so that you can put them together and share them. Invite people to have their best day yet, because if you let people sample our products, it's just a numbers game. Some of those people are going to love them, and some of them are going to want to share them with others, and some want to go out and build substantial residual income businesses. So we have this power of three behind it with a plan, and we'll teach you all the steps and how to be successful every Thursday night at 7 o'clock Mountain Time. XANGO Corporate does a training, and so you'll be able to just plug right into that. And you'll be able to learn everything about our products and our compensation plan, how to sample, how to invite, how to follow up, the system, and all of that. But We're here tonight to talk about what I believe is the next billion-dollar brand with XANGO, and that's the XANGO AERIS line that was just launched at convention. I'm so excited about this product. I was blessed to be part of a group that got to test market a little bit early. We had to sign NDAs, non-disclosure agreements. I kept it, but my face did not. And so a lot of people started asking, oh my gosh, what are you doing? And I was not even allowed to confirm that there was ever even anything coming, but they're all like, come on, I know. I'm like, oh. But I want you to know that now that everyone has been using this product line has been experiencing some pretty dramatic results. So I'm going to just quickly go over the products and Dr. Templeman's going to tell us how they work and all of that. We've got a marine collagen. I'll let him tell you all about it. We have an instant eye gel, which instantly gives you results. Now, here's what's sexy and exciting to me about this is there's other companies out there with products that give you instant results, but they have toxic ingredients that actually damage the skin. The longer you use them, the worse your skin is. Whereas ours, the longer you use it, the more permanent, long-lasting the results are, and the better for you it is. So that's what XANGO is all about. And this eye renewal concentrate, what to expect. I'm going to go through this quick because he's got the same slides. You're going to get benefits, fine lines, wrinkles, under eye bags, deep wrinkles, and dark circles, and coloration, and even texture, dryness. And again, I'm going through it quick for a reason. We have a pack that you can purchase, and a whole program if you want to build a business on it. So these products, they're about $350 to $500 if you were to go to the competition, try to get similar products. We put them together, if you bought them individually, it'd be $190. In a pack, $175. But here's the deal. If you become a wholesale customer, a preferred customer with XANGO, that means you sign up on our automatic delivery program every month, or you become a distributor for $135, including tax and shipping, and this is huge. And then we have a system behind it. You can get two systems for $249. That's like $125 each. So if you're a two-member household that wants to use the products, this is a good way even for customers. But if you're serious about building the business, by the way, if you retail one, if there's just one, you can get your products for less, right? Retail out a system for $175. We have a five-pack system you can get involved in, and if you do that, then you can get your products down even for lower. If you retail three of them, you get two systems free and for only like $90. If you retail four, you get your system for free and put some profit in your pocket. Our best one is our 10-pack system. Here's the deal. Anybody who comes in with a 10-pack at this company and shows they're serious about the business, as distributors, we earn commissions, and we'll invest that commission back to you to say as a thank you for believing in yourself and for trying it. And you know what? XANGO has a money-back guarantee for 30 days. If you came in with a 10-pack and you went out and tried to do the business and you shared with people and you did parties and you invited them here and they tried it and everything and you didn't like it and you weren't successful, by the end of the month you could just call back and you have to return because that's personal use. The other eight you would. But it's no risk. It's no risk. This business is no risk whatsoever. And so if you do that, you could actually, and I'll go into the numbers another time or later if you want, but you can put $500 profit in your pocket and get three systems for free. And that's a heck of a way to build the business. And now you got some product and inventory to share with other people. If you do that, these are some ranks. You can actually hit these ranks really quickly. One level of duplication, if I came in with a 10-pack and I got four people who came in with a 10-pack, I'd be a 5K. If I duplicated that, I could be a 20K. If I duplicated that, I could be a premier. So we have tools. My XANGO Builder gives us all kinds of stuff to share. It gives us websites and social media posts, presentations, videos, all kinds of stuff put together. It gives us a smartphone app. So if you guys get a text tomorrow telling you to take Ignite, it came from that app right there. It's pretty exciting. It gives you four individual replicated websites. The AERIS just to promote AERIS, the MyMB30 just to promote Limitless, or the whole Pro Line, the best day yet, or Ageless. We haven't even talked about any of XANGO's products. And this is what your XANGO AERIS site would look like. You get your own little phone number and information up at the top. And if somebody clicked buy now, they would sign up as your customer or your distributor, or they could pay retail. And if they pay retail, you will get the retail bonus, the $40 difference on your commission check. So we use Netflix model. And I'm just going to go through these really super quickly. This is how we build our business. We simply share the products with other people. Our company pays us to use and share products with others. We have a simple, generous, global, and rewarding compensation plan. It's based on volume. It's a simple way to build and qualify. We pay out 50%. The average company in the network marketing industry pays out 32%. I just want you to know that. They say up to 50% or as much as whatever, or whatever they say. The truth is the average company in the network marketing industry pays out 32%. So that's the truth. XANGO pays out 50%. That's why we produce more $1 million earners and more people in between, more $1,000 a month earners, more $500 a month earners. So we pay out 50% to distributors, 50% to the companies, and it makes us partners. So you'll see those words with other companies. It's global. Here's what's really cool. We have a global bonus plan. We're operating right now in 43 nations. People can buy this product, and we're already launched in many nations, and it'll be globally expanded by the end of February. And we have people all over the world paying for the product in their own currency. The system of XANGO AERIS has 100 points, regardless of the currency that it was purchased in. So we calculate to points for the purposes of the math and doing the comp plan, and then they calculate it again to your own currency for your commission. So it's pretty exciting. We've got Nothing Beats Free program to get free products. We have our Customer Connect program for people working with customers. Automatic Delivery Point Rewards program. You get free products sent to you just by being on ADP. You can qualify for Drive Your Own Dream, which is a nice little, a lot of people call it a car program. Power Start bonuses that give you weekly bonuses on all your customers and all your brand new distributors. And global bonus pools for leaders and for early ranks on customers. So a lot of really exciting stuff. We can go into it another time. You can get compensation plan training. Make sure the person who invited you here gives you a link. And I'll give you that link at the end also, where you can go and get the details on the comp plan. I'm just trying to, but this is how it is. We're looking to find some people and partner with them. We're looking for three teams to get to this position called Premier, where the average income is about five figures a month. Now, you might want to make $500 a month more. It might be $1,000 a month more. It might be $2,000. But if you want to earn five figures a month or more, we have a plan. We can show you what you need to do to accomplish that. And we have lots of people that have done that. So it's all based on you finding team members. These are people who want to share the products with others and helping them to create volume, which means sponsoring other distributors and customers themselves. And this is just a potential. Now, this is a lot. And you don't even have to look way down here. I just want to show you a couple of the levels. All it is about this, it's all it means. When you sponsor distributors and they sponsor distributors, you can get up to 9 levels of referrals, which, by the way, is huge. Most companies that have a unit level, 6 or 7 is a good plan. 8 is really, really good. 9 is few and far between. And the ones that do have deeper levels pay 1 or 2%. We pay 5% all the way to the 9th level. 2% on your own, it's leveraging. 5% on all the referrals made through 9 levels of distributors in your organization. And if everybody just did 100 a month, this is just the math. 5 levels, that's what our 5Ks get. That's 1,800 plus a month. Plus their car bonuses. Plus maybe they're qualifying for a Customer Connect and global bonus pools on the customer program and. Just on the distributor income. Now, what I want to say is this is not a reflection of what you're earning. This is a reflection of what would be earned if you had 9 levels of duplication. If you found 3 people that did 100 a month, who found 3 who did 100, who found 3 who did 100, that is the math. I'll show you the comp plan, you go through the training, but of course you're gonna have to find the right 3. You're gonna have to find the right 3. You're gonna have to be the right 3 for the person who invited you, and you're gonna have to find the right 3 if you expect any kind of duplication at all. Maybe it's gonna take you 5, 10, 15, 20 to find 3. Here's some statistics. Over 140 families in XANGO have earned more than $1 million in commissions in their career, which is huge. You know, the number 2 company in the first 10 years alone, XANGO did over $100 million earners. The second closest company did 18. We are more than 5 times as good as the second best company in this industry at producing $1 million earners. But more exciting than that is the 170,000 people that are earning $1,000 a month or more, and the 250,000 people that are earning $500 a month or more. In XANGO, it's not about the rich and the poor and the few and far between. See, every company's got some number 1, number 2 dogs. But I'll tell you what, you take the first 100, the first 1,000, compare them to any other company in this industry, will beat them hands down. So we have 2 trips a year you can qualify for the moment you sign your distributor application. The next one's in February. We're still on the qualification for that. In this room right here, right now, how many people raise your hand if you're already qualified for the trip to Mexico? We've already got, and some of them must have stepped into the garage because there's more than that. How many of you are going to go to Mexico, just haven't quite got there yet? Several more hands in the room that have lots of points. Thank you very much. And all you have to do to qualify for points to get on this trip is sponsor customers and distributors. That's it. XANGO rewards you for sharing our products with other people. So the goal isn't about more money. The goal is living life on your own terms. And if you grab a hold of the opportunity, there's a lot of people like myself and the Tom Carroll Ferry in the room that have earned more than $1 million in the company. But we want to work with you, the next generation. We want to pass the torch to you. So all you have to do to be successful is pick up the torch and run. So that is the opportunity portion. Now we're going to go into some product, and we are going to hear about this incredible product line from Dr. Templeman. I have known him for 13 years, still practicing when he first heard about this mangosteen fruit, but ended up spending and devoting his life to the discovery of this. He goes to Thailand, but you're there like 6 months out of the year. And I'll let him tell you a little bit more about that, but he's learned some incredible things, and he has such a way of sharing the things with us about the mangosteen fruit, which is a key ingredient and very important part of our product line. So please welcome Dr. Fred Templeman.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for having me here with you tonight. Just a couple of words first about why a doctor, a physician, trained in a regular medical school, because I didn't, would be interested in spending time talking to people about supplements. I have been practicing medicine. I'm still a licensed physician. I don't have a practice where I see patients in my office every day. Haven't for some time now. I enjoy the contact that I had with people, but overall I felt like there would be a better opportunity to help people by teaching them what they needed to know in order to avoid some of the pitfalls that come with the standard medical package that you may be presented with when you get ill. And that was brought to my attention forcefully when about 8 years into practice, well, actually, no, it was 12 years into practice, I had a 26-year-old young man who became terribly depressed. Now, he became depressed despite the fact that he'd had many challenges in his life and he'd never been depressed before, so it was an unusual thing for him to be depressed. And we gave him a medication prior to this that did not have, in the big figures, the question of depression. Way down deep, if you went digging, you know, how you get the commercials on TV and then somebody in a monotone, not to attract your attention, starts talking about death and disorders and awful things. And if you did listen to that, you would probably say, why on earth would anybody use those things? Now, he was given the commonest class of medication here in the United States, antidepressants. You'll be interested to know that antidepressants, following a good study, a very good study done a number of years ago, you have to treat 10 people to get one person who's going to respond in a positive manner from these antidepressants. But you only have to treat 3 before you give them some serious side effect, sexual or otherwise. But this is a class of drugs that is used very, very commonly. And we gave this antispasmodic drug, very relatively, I thought, safe drug, to this young man who was paralyzed. And he obtained relief from that he was having, but then he crashed into this terrible depression. And I did not notice, the other doctors in his care did not notice, that depression was one of the side effects to that particular medication. We just thought, endogenous depression, it's around everywhere. Many times we never know why the person is depressed. And we sent him, I practiced with him for probably about 5 months, trying various regimens of antidepressants and other things to try and help him. And then I sent him up the road to the big hospital, to the psychiatry ward. And they put him in the hospital for 5 days, and then they sent him back to me. And when he came back, he was unable to look after himself the way he had previously. He was kind of sitting. And they had announced to me, well, he's not suicidal anymore. Well, of course he wasn't. He was drugged very, very heavily. I didn't send him home. I felt uncomfortable sending him home. I admitted him to my little hospital and put him there. And next morning when they were feeding him his breakfast, he died. His heart stopped. Now, we were luckily right across from the nursing station where we were able to get the paddles and shock him immediately. And we got him back. And he didn't even realize what had happened. He wondered why he had oatmeal all over the place, because as we were working with him, there was oatmeal everywhere. But the fact was that he died. And I took the time, I shut down my office that day, and I went and I took a look at all of these things and realized that the doctors in that hospital had given him 3 upper limit of normal of an antidepressant medication that was known to cause cardiac arrhythmias. I had a big argument with the psychiatrist up the road, asked him how many people he'd killed. He told me he didn't think he'd killed anybody. I said, well, if this man had gone home, there would have been nothing on an autopsy to show why he died. But he would have died like that. And there's a good study that shows that about 180,000 people a year die. And that's probably a very gross underestimation. So that's how a family doctor, one of the health patients, decided that he was going to take a look at other things which could possibly make a difference with the complaints that his patients were coming in to see him for, and not place them in the same jeopardy as simply writing a prescription. Because I saw 45 patients a day on a good day, and I would write probably 60 prescriptions. That's what a doctor has been trained to do. Now we understand a little bit more, and the public needs to know. You have to become educated about the normal functioning of your body. If you have something that is a disease that has been labeled and you've been told about it, and it can be seen either in signs or symptoms or in some of the blood work that you have, then you need to know as much about that disease as the doctor who is treating you. Ideally, more. And it is entirely possible today, because of the internet and the way that knowledge has been rendered to the layman's level, you can know enough about this to remain in control of your health. Now, many doctors do not endorse supplementation. It's a difficult place to go out into the supplement market and to know where you're going to spend your money, because you need criteria in the same way that you need criteria to decide about which doctor to go to, which hospital to go to. Those statistics are there. They will tell you what doctors' records are, what hospitals do well when they have people admitted to them. You need to know these kinds of things about supplements, and you need to be generally educated as much about the management of your health as you are about the management of your money. I see smiles because perhaps some of you don't manage your money well. Thank goodness my wife manages our money well. By the way, I'm not an employee of XANGO, and I am not a distributor. I think that not been a word up. I did not become that way in order that I can speak from a distance and in a relatively unbiased way. Now, someone asked me, are you biased towards supplements? The answer is absolutely. When I was practicing medicine and writing prescriptions for things that had to do with the GI tract, for things that had to do with headaches, muscle aches, pains, arthritis, I found that I could replace about 17 different medications with a fruit juice. Now, initially, I was quite astonished by that. I really, truly was. I was using this in a different form than you have right now, well before the company was ever founded. And I was using it with my patients where I had run up against the medicines weren't working for them, or they weren't getting better. And I started to use the mangosteen product, and I became absolutely convinced, so convinced that it was going to be important, that in 2004, after 2 years of using it in my patients, I said, hey, this is going to be the biggest supplement ever. And my partner, who is a professor at a medical school, coined the term superfruit. And then everybody jumped on the wagon and everything was a superfruit. A pineapple was a superfruit, a pomegranate was a superfruit, the goji berry was a superfruit, and everyone was saying that these things are superfruits. Well, they're not. Because simply put, while they have things within them that the body can use to reinforce the systems that it needs to reinforce, they only have one class of, or two classes at most. They do not have what the mangosteen has, which is five different classes with elements in there strong enough in terms of the potency and also in the quantity to make a difference when you use it. Now remember this, do not confuse supplementation with medicine. Too many people tend to think that a supplement is just a weak medicine. That's not true. Medicines are designed in the Western medical model on a very reductionistic scheme. They're looking for a silver bullet that will go into the body and interfere with a single enzymatic reaction that will have some difference in a disease and the disease process. And they don't want to do any ever seen one of those silver bullets. There's only one drug that I know of that has no side effects. Because the side effects are the unintended consequences of having that kind of a model. Supplementation, contrary to this model, is not intended to go into the body and to mess around and change things in a way that is designed to make a difference in disease. It's not to go in there and change things. Your body, Hippocrates, who was the father of Western medicine, said, respect your body's ability to heal itself. Now, if I was paid only for the patients that I have given prescriptions to and they got better, I would be a poor man. Because usually what happens is the doctor gives you a medicine, and if it doesn't make you worse, you usually get better on your own with your body managing that process. And the doctor and the medicine take credit for it. Really, the body tries to keep itself healthy, to breathe until the last breath, to beat until the last beat of the heart. The body tries to survive. And it's a magnificent organism. What we know in medicine about this body will fill university libraries, but what we don't know will fill the universe, and we still don't understand it. But the body knows. And so supplementation is involved in simply giving your body enough of what it needs to see to do the job of repair and protection. That's the body's major function, repair and protect. I guess it could go on the side of a car. You know, what do they say? Protect and
serve.
Serve. Well, repair and protect. That's what the body does. Now, let's jump from there all the way to here about this. Why would I bother to endorse a product line that has to do with anti-aging? Well, I'm aging and I don't like it. And most of us are aging, and until you're about 30, you're not really conscious of the process. You just don't think about it. I remember one day when I was about 40, I woke up after being on call most of the night, getting a couple hours of sleep, getting ready to go. So I was haggard, and I went into the bathroom, and I looked in a mirror, and I said, Dad! Because I looked like my father looked. When he was in his 40s and 50s, that's what I remember. And I started looking like him. And the aging process starts, really, you peak somewhere in your late 20s. And after that, nature treats you as if you were a salmon. They're not terribly concerned with what goes on after you reproduce. And so your body declines. And it declines invisibly in an internal way. in the system, which seems to age more rapidly than anything else, is the GI tract. But the apparent signs of aging take place first in the face. And they take place first around the eyes. And the reason for that is relatively simple. Your heart beats like this all the time. And what's the next most common movement in your body, except
blinking,
the generation
blinking.
Blinking, right. You're awake for 15, 16 hours a day in some cases, and you're constantly blinking. Your eyes and the muscles around your eyes are working hard every day, all day, with literally thousands of contractions. Now, I happen to be the medical director of a medical spa. And so I am there where people are coming to spend money, lots of it, believe me, to be able to slow down the process of aging, or at least to disguise the external appearance of the face generally and why we age. And they spend a 3-ounce bottle of something that is essentially nothing but antioxidant. And its retail value in that spa is $157. It smells bad. It has to be protected from sunlight, but it works very well at doing certain things that people want done. And what I'm saying to you is, this is better than that for one major reason. This is not full of toxins. That is, because people don't read labels, or if they do, they do not understand the dangers of the things that could be introduced to their body as pharmaceuticals, which are cosmetics. It's really a very dangerous place. I'd suggest you go and look at EWG, the Environmental Working Group. They have a very nice website. They have a list of the different products that can be found in cosmetics that is called the Skin Deep Database, and they score between 1 and 4 as to what their potential danger is. Now, nobody can have a perfectly safe product, but 5 years ago, when the first sort of cosmetic eye product appeared on the market out there, it was exciting because people could just put it on, and in minutes there was a visible change in what was going on around their eyes, the place where aging shows first. And they were very enthusiastic about that. And a lot of companies wanted to get on the bandwagon. There are a lot of products out there. XANGO was not first to market with this. They came slowly, carefully, after watching for 5 years the pitfalls that the first guys jumped in and it was out there, which had a very striking effect on people, caused 30% of the people to have adverse reactions. Almost sounds like a drug, doesn't it? Did things to them that they didn't like, even though there were some things that happened with the product that they did like. And so XANGO waited, watched, followed that trend, and decided to come on board with products that did not have the same kind of toxic shock value that the other products out there had, and yet would provide for the people who purchased it value for their money. Because you can waste your money in the supplement market in exactly the same way you can waste it in any other endeavor. I mean, first of all, where is the box? Oh, there she is. How long? And I go, have I finished?
Well, here's what I'll say. If there's anybody that has to leave early,
right,
you may do so. But I think we want to hear what you have to say, and if it's a few minutes longer, so.
Okay. First of all, the enemies are your lifestyle, frankly. If you look at the face of a person who is a smoker, they appear one decade over by the time they're 30. Just by the time they're 30, they appear to be about 37 or 38. And if you're 40, you appear to be 50. Smoking by itself alone is going to age you at approximately twice twice, as far as your skin is concerned, at the twice the rate. Now, if you work out on a farm and are exposed to the sun all of the time, your face looks about 10 years older than your chronological age because you're exposed to it. And if you're not protecting yourself, then you have big problems. And know also that, and you've heard of people who have to have their lens removed because they've got cataracts, that is due absolutely to sun exposure. There's virtually nothing to cataracts. So living in a world where the sun is important to us, eating the foods we eat, having the bad habits that we have, is largely responsible for how rapidly we age. And like I told you, that process starts in the late 20s, and then it's downhill from there. So gravity is the other factor that affects the aging of the skin. I have a lot of grandkids. I've got 35 of them. One was born 2 days ago. But yeah.
Wow.
Well, I had 10 kids.
Wow.
I didn't have 10 kids. My wife had 10 kids. So I had one of the five-year-olds with me not too long ago, and we were going through a photo album, and he looked at pictures of my graduation from medical school. And I wasn't young. I graduated from medical school at age 40. I didn't go to medical school until I was 36. I had another career too, actually. So when he looked at the picture of me, and then he said, "Who's that?" And I said, "That's me." And he looked at the picture, and then he looked at me like a five-year-old would. And he said, "That's not you." The nose. Doesn't the nose look the same? And he said, "Yeah." And he said, "But it doesn't look like you, Grandpa." And I said, "Well, I was younger then. And look at how my face has changed." And you know what he did? He touched my face and then he grabbed the wattle. And he went like this. And he pronounced very solemnly, looking at the picture and then looking at me, "Grandpa, you're melting." And that image stuck with me because, in fact, that's just about what happens with our face as we age. The structures that give it form and that make it firm are under the effect of lifestyle, under the effect of the environment, toxins. It is breaking down. And as it breaks down, gravity takes over. When you remove the structure that is there to keep your face nice and smooth, and if you take a child's hand, for example, and you pinch a baby's hand, you can't even see 1 second after. That's why people like to pinch babies, I think, because it just snaps right back into position. But if you're over 40 and you pinch your hand and hold it for just a moment, the wrinkle's still there. It doesn't go away. Why? The subcutaneous support and the collagen that gives your body and your skin its texture and its firmness have degenerated to the point where it cannot do what it used to do. And we lose about 1% of the collagen in our total body, but certainly from our face, per year after we are 30. That's why, not surprisingly, we see the effects of gravity in the face. Now, let's take a look at what we're talking about. We're talking largely about something called collagen. Collagen is a protein, and it's made up of building blocks called amino acids, which are extracted from the food that we eat or from the supplements that we may be taking. The collagen is, or could be, compared to a pearl. Three or four or five or ten, but a small number, relatively speaking, of these amino acids and place them together, you get what is called a peptide. And you'll notice later on that we're talking about peptides in the product. So the peptide is a group of amino acids on its way to becoming a pearl necklace. And so there's the amino acid, the peptide, and collagen is a protein. The most abundant protein in your body. There are 16 different types, but over 75% of it is type 1 collagen. And that's the type that is in skin, bones, muscles, and sinews primarily. And so that's the one that if you're going to supplement and make up for two things that are happening, one, your GI tract is no longer as efficient at taking out the amino acids from food as it was before, and so you can't really go and change the GI tract, so you have to produce more and put more in so that there is more presented to the gut, and the gut will take the percentage that it can across. That's how you make up for a deficit. The second way you may make up for a deficit is to take elements that are in collagen and put them in a carrier that is going to go through the skin and put them directly on the skin where a difference would be made. So how does the collagen support the body? Well, there's an image that shows you that collagen is made up of three chains, two which are exactly the same strands of amino acids wraps around it. So in a way, you can look at the collagen as if it were, but if the collagen were like a twisted steel cable that holds a bridge, fibrils marked across. And we know that when you look at the tensile strength of collagen, it's stronger than steel. It's stronger than steel, but it still breaks down in our body. And we sag as a result. And we don't feel as good because our muscle mass is disappearing at about the same rate. And these are processes over which we have far more control than you normally think that you would. You can do stuff about this. Now, a tendon, that's my daughter, by the way. She's she's stronger than I am. She runs 10 miles a day in the mountains. And she tells me she's going to live to be 120. And her husband says, well, you'll have to get somebody to change your Pampers because I'm not going to be. But the tendon is made up of these fibrils of collagen. So they're in muscle, they're in tendon, and they are in the structure of the face. It's almost like rebar. You can build a concrete building with concrete, but concrete by itself is brittle. It will not take load stresses the same way that if you put something more flexible inside and stronger, then you can have a structure which will bear weight and which will be able to resist the kinds of things that can happen to buildings because it is more flexible and it has something stronger within it. Collagen is skin. There are seven layers of epidermis if you want to get into the details of it. Then underneath it, you have what is called the cutaneous levels that go all the way down. This is, have we got a pointer in here?
We do, but it doesn't show up on a TV screen.
Okay. Well, yeah, that's true. They don't show on TV screens. So you can see the blood vessels down below. Now, all of this stuff in here is called ground substance. It's fat, largely. Now, take out the structures, supporting structures for the fat, and what do you think it's going to do? It's going to puddle. It's going to melt. And that's what's happening. So we go at the business of making a difference, not only in the top layers of skin, but in the dermis, and down in the hypodermis, by supplying systemically the elements, the amino acids that are required to rebuild type 1 collagen. Let's take a look at, that's David Easton. Okay. What happens to collagen as we age? Take a look. You can see. See the difference? The guy needs his teeth capped. Okay. Now, here's the products, and we're going to look at them individually. This was the worst patient that we ever had. We thought if anybody needed a makeover, it was this guy. And after 2 weeks, he looked like that. And this was next after 4 weeks. As the clock turned back. We can't really turn the clock back, but we can make a difference. And here's a question. Why do I care about a clean skincare product? Well, because the toxins in the bad skincare products, for which you pay more money, are really very, very dangerous. Even though they give you good things, you always have that little underlying, I guess I should stay on the screen, shouldn't I? So you have that underlying monotone voice telling you about all the potential things that are bad. So it makes a difference how the product is made. Why marine collagen and absorption, okay? We're mammals. We can get collagen from calves. We can get collagen that's bovine sourced. We can get collagen from pigs, porcine, or we can get collagen from chickens. But unfortunately, we can also get viruses and other very, very small organisms that constitute the beginnings of diseases from the same sorts of animals. But we don't share any real diseases with fish. And that's why marine collagen. And we're not talking here about taking mollusks and shrimp and things like that, which are highly allergenic and which a lot of people are allergic to. We're talking about taking the skin from fish. Now, has anybody ever skinned a fish or filleted a fish? Sure. Think of how tough that skin is. It is not easy. Think of a catfish. You can take a catfish skin. Well, they make shoes out of fish skin. They make purses out of fish skin. So it really is nothing except protein. And it has all the proteins that we have in our type 1 collagen. All of them, identical. And really, type 1 collagen is quite different than a lot of the other proteins in the body, which is globulin. But I'm not old like Dr. Templeman. This is David Warner said. Why should I worry about it? And the fact is that if you've still got a face that you can smile at in the mirror and not have a little bit of a shock effect, then you want to keep it that way as long as you can. And prevention matters. If you took a look at Beverly Hollister, who is one of the founders of the company, Beverly, and I won't tell you her age, I know, but I won't tell you her age. But Beverly virtually has no wrinkles on her face at all. She's from southern Alabama. And so she's been exposed by having the sun in her environment for years. But I don't think the sun has ever gone on her face, ever, ever. Because she knew very, very early the dangers of that kind of thing. And so she made a difference. You would therefore not be able to look at her and guess her chronological age. Because her face has not aged like mine or like most people's. And you can't go back and redo that. But you certainly, if you're younger, can prevent the changes that are going to take place. Now, this is Ampanan, that's not, but it's an anagram for antioxidant, micronutrients, and peptides. Let's take a look at them. Here are the ingredients. And I'm not going to go lecture where I actually go through and talk about all these things and why they're in the product. But notice there's nothing in there which is bad. Okay? They're all things that if you look at it, you'd say, wow, that's good. You might not recognize astragalus, but astragalus is one of the elements from nature that has great impact on the anti-aging at the level of the mitochondria, the little subcellular organelles that produce all of the energy for our body. That makes a big difference. Then you start looking at micronutrients. Now, micronutrients, the macronutrients are fat, protein, and carbohydrate. Fat is essentially a means of storing energy and making padding. Essentially, that's what it is. Carbohydrate is pretty much only energy. And protein is the structural stuff and the messenger stuff and a lot more. So if you looked at those three and figured they're all essential. But if you looked at them, because we need a lot of them every day, they're called macronutrients. And micronutrients are things that we do not require that much of. So vitamins and minerals and different things like that are factors. And they're involved in metabolism, not as an actual structural thing in the metabolism, but it makes the metabolism go faster. It's a catalyst, which speeds up the rate of reaction when you're looking at metabolic processes. And so therefore, essential if you're going to be doing anything to change the speed of reaction in your skin and build what you need to build. Peptides. We showed you what a peptide was. This is marine peptides, and those are two other things that are in there that are signaling molecules, and I'll explain what I mean by that in just a minute. So what does AMP do? Well, it makes a difference in fine lines and wrinkles. You can take a look at that and you can see that it's real. And the one thing to always look for is there somebody tricking the photography? So look at the light. See if the light is being cast in pretty much the same way. Look at the aperture of the eye. Is it pretty? I was looking at some of these before after pictures, and there was a what we call a vendor, somebody who was sending us in things. And David and I were looking at it, and we were looking at the eyes, and he said, "Wow, that's a real striking change." I said, "Yeah, they changed their hair color too. It was two different people." So you're not about being deceived, but take a look to see whether you've got a read. Does it look like the same eye? Is the eye in approximately the same position? Is the lighting the same? Is the magnification the same? Because those are all of the little tricks that they play. Now, can you see a difference? Okay? Now, you might look at that and say, wow, that's pretty quite different. Now, I could give her exactly the same thing with Botox by paralyzing the muscle. And it isn't a simple question of squeezing or not squeezing. It's really that the muscles are paralyzed when you do Botox. Somebody asked me a question about Botox. They said, if people are doing Botox, should they also be doing this? And I would say, absolutely. Because the wrinkle doesn't disappear just because the muscle doesn't contract. That kind of ridge in the skin that needs to be repaired exists even if the skin is not contracting, simply because the muscles that would contract it have been paralyzed temporarily. So there's a before and after. It looks after something else, the under eye bags and discolorations, the things for which people go and see plastic surgeons to get what are called blepharoplasties and spend a lot of money to do that, $8,000 to $12,000 to have a brow lift and your eyes done. Really quite expensive and painful, and not always with a good outcome. Where do the bags come from? Anybody got an idea? The bags are?
It's part of melting.
Well, it is part of the melting. What's happening is that your eye is sitting cushioned in the orbit by fat, held in position because it has a collagen fibrils going through it and providing a matrix in a three-dimensional form to hold that fat in place so that if you get a blow on the eye is not damaged, because the eye is not the kind of a structure that you can hit hard without damaging it. So they cushion it by putting fat, well, they, God, cushions it by putting fat in behind it. And over time, as the collagen disappears from there, where's it gonna go? Down. And that fat begins to leak out and comes out here, and the skin, which is nice and taut in youth, has begun to bulge outward as well. And so gravity pulls this down. Now there's discoloration. Some people actually have real dark circles. That dark circle comes from the fact that the circulation in that area of dysfunctional skin and fat is not as good as it was before. And the hemoglobin, which is the red pigment in our blood that carries the oxygen, leaks out of the capillaries and into the tissues themselves. And then the body degrades that and tries to get rid of it, but they're pigments and they hang around. Some of them are kind of bluish, some are green. They've got names, but you don't need to know what they are. And you can take a look and see that there's a change in the puffiness, but here's the color. Those pigments and carry them away, and that's indeed what does happen with the eye complex. Now here you can see on the left, that's the neutral one, and then you can see on the right there's a weak solution, there's a stronger solution, and there's the strongest solution going from right to left that picks up those pigments and carries them away back into the bloodstream and removes and makes a difference in the color of those eyes. Dull, uneven texture. That's really a question of skin elasticity. There are structures in there made up of collagen and other things in them that are elastic. And that elastin breaks down. And that's what we're talking about here. It makes a difference when you build it back up. Moisturizing is part of the reason why the skin has a tenderness and a deep, not a tenderness, but a a softness to it. And that same grandson who told me I was melting went to his pool this summer. And he said to me, "Whoa, look at your legs. It looks like a road map." Now, but to a greater degree, the skin overlying it disappears, and you can see them a lot easier. That's the story. Now, I want to talk to you just a little bit about, and we'll finish up in about 2 minutes. This is the mangosteen fruit. The outside portion of it is the part that is most important for nutrition, but it's the white inside that everybody eats, because the outside makes you puke. If you try and eat it, it just really makes you very, very sick. So the company XANGO was able to do something, able to take that whole fruit, mash it up, that's really all they do with it, and then mix it with essences. Now you'll see on the bottom, it'll say juice, fruit juice, fruit juice, because you don't have a word essence in the kind of line, but it isn't a fruit juice. It's not pear juice, it's not grape or the juice of grapes. It's an essence that has been distilled down very much like essential oils, to the point where if you put it on your tongue, you feel like you've just had a bushel of whatever it is that you've had. It's so, so strong in terms of its taste that it is mixed in to block the tongue from tasting the crappy outside of the mangosteen. So that's why those other things are there. They're not there because pear juice has a value or because grape juice has a value. They're there to make this thing taste okay. And diet, exercise, and supplementation is always important. That's what I said way back in 2002, and I still say it. You cannot expect to eat the wrong things, not to exercise, and to be able to supplement yourself to health. You can't. There is nothing that can replace exercise, and there is nothing that can replace wise choices in diet. And if you want to optimize your health, then you also need to become knowledgeable about what supplements to add to your body, what gives you value for your money to be able to have you. Now, I'm just going to show you something else. The best proof of the utility of something that comes from nature is the fact that people have been using it for centuries by the millions. People are not stupid. They don't keep eating something that hurts them. And they don't keep eating and buying and paying money for something that doesn't make them feel better or doesn't do something for them. So that's the very best. When you're looking at supplements, see what the history says. Does the history say this has value? Have millions of people around the world where they can get it? Have they been using it? And have they been using it for a long time? That's better than any science. But we live in a world that adores science. And so if you're going to look for that, then the second thing you look for is, are the scientists also interested in this? Because, for example, the Golgi berry, over the period of time that I'm going to be talking to you about the studies on the mangosteen, the Golgi berry had 38 studies. The noni fruit had 128 studies. So 128 groups of people who were PhDs or MDs looked at the Golgi berry, because people said, "Hey, I've been taking something with Golgi berry in it, and it makes me feel this or that, and that's better." So they were looking for it. Why are the scientists looking for it? Are they really interested in our health? Hell no. They want to find the active ingredient to make into a drug, because then their university cleans up and they get to be involved in the patent and the things that get done down the road. So the motivation to do all of the studies that get done on natural products is always to try and find the actives that we can either synthesize and make into something as an active in a drug so that we can get a lot of money. But they don't follow blind alleys. And if they don't find the things they're looking for, they don't continue to spend their time and their money doing this. Now, of the studies I'm going to show you, only one was paid on a randomized controlled double-blind trial, which happens to be the best kind of evidence as far as modern science is concerned. And the company did it because nobody was going to do it if they didn't do it. So they did one. Now there are five or six of them, but they're very rare. But let's take a look at the other kinds of studies. Now, this is the number of publications in medical journals. In 1980 to 1989, there were just a very few, didn't even make it to 20, really, in that period of time. From 1990 to 1999, a little bit more. But something happened in 2002, and you see that doubled. Now look what happens in the next years. First of all, that was the year 2002 that was formed. XANGO is responsible for all of this research, even though they didn't pay for only one study. 2005 to 2008, wow, quadruples. Now look what happens. 2009 to 2013, quadruples again. Why? Because the scientists are doing the studies, and the thing that they were hoping they were going to see at the end of their study, they find it. Why are there only 38 papers in the same period of time on the Golgi berry on PubMed? Because they thought they were going to see something good, and they didn't find it. And so you don't keep running down blind alleys. The noni fruit has a wonderful element in it, only it stays around for only nanoseconds. It's difficult to be able to get the kind of interest because they're never going to be able to make a drug from it. Now, will they be able to make a drug from the mangosteen? Absolutely. The Japanese have already done it. It's called panxanthal. Costs $400 a month. It's an anti-inflammatory element because one of the things that the mangosteen does best is it's the strongest natural anti-inflammatory that exists out there. And that's about the same strength as your ibuprofen in terms of what I have seen over the years as the effect. So, is it strong? Yes, absolutely. Does anybody get stomach ulcers from it? No. Do they have kidney failure because of it? No. Do they have liver failure because of it? No. Can they use it every day in large amounts and get relief from pain? Very often. So, 2015, there we go. There are now over 600 papers that are on the mangosteen and its extracts. This is not on XANGO. These are on the things that are in the product because it is nothing except the complete rendering of the natural product. No additives except for one preservative. And I talked them early on in the process, I talked them out of putting any kind of preservative in. It was a very interesting experience. There was a non-pathological fungus that got involved in the bottling process, and the bottles began to blow up because they were made of glass. So that was the end of that experiment because the insurance people who had to pay for all the cleanups put a preservative back in this were not going to give you insurance. And so it's in there for a reason in a very, very small amount. You would get more of the same thing if you drank a bottle of Coke than if you drank a whole bottle of this. It is a natural product imitation. This is an antifungal that cranberries, for example, elaborate to keep themselves safe from funguses. If you ate a small handful of cranberries, you'd get a lot more of this natural preservative than if you drank a whole bottle of the product. So I'm satisfied that it is safe. So this is what you can expect. This is Blade Pulsing, and I guess you've got a thing you want to play? Because there
if
are three...
successfully got it in there, but...
Let me just say one more thing before we put it in. Let's see if we can get it. First of all, compare the rebuilding that you might want to do around your eyes to a fifth floor walk up in a very classy area in New York. They still exist. These are buildings without elevators. They have a big stairwell in them. And you're going up there and you bought this $2 million apartment and now you're going to rip out the lath and the plaster and the things that you don't want from 100 years ago. And you're going to refurbish the whole thing the way you want it. Where are the elements going to come from that you will be using to put up the wallboard and do whatever you're going to use? They're going to come in and they're going to go up five floors and they're going to come to the top. So that's the supply of amino acids and other elements. For example, well, we won't go into the other elements, we have time. But that's the stuff that comes in through the mouth, goes to the gut, and then you attract the body's attention to the eyes. You do that with signaling molecules. It's like the foreman leaning over the top of the stairwell and say, hey guys, hey, where you're supposed to go. Because the aging process, the body looks after things that go wrong with it, like that. As soon as something goes, you drive a little splinter into your finger, and within seconds, the white blood cells are testing, getting ready, calling out the reinforcements to make sure that you don't pick up an infection from that. But when your eyes, over years, begin to be damaged, and I'm talking about the skin around your eyes, the body doesn't notice it. It happens so slowly that the repair process is not going on. And so you need some signaling molecules which are in the complex that say, hey, there's something going wrong with the eyes. And we don't have stem cells in this product, but the body has stem cells and they're circulating all the time. And where do they get off? From the circulatory system. They get off wherever there's a problem. And so if you can signal and say, hey, this is the construction site. This is where we want all those things that you just swallowed. We want those amino acids here. We want the different things that are required for structural repair. We want them here, we want them now. That's what the gel, the thing that makes the difference in a matter of minutes, that's cosmetic. It's not going to make the big difference. The big difference is going to come over time when you start to call the elements that you take in through the mouth and the things that will go through the skin into the construction site around the eyes. Thank you. What do you want to do, Bob?
Thank you very much. If it's okay, and anyone has to leave, we can just leave whenever. And I might have you take the mic for this only because people might mingle and talk. There's probably a couple of questions that some folks might have, and I just thought if you could take a few questions, that would be awesome. One of the things I'm bringing up here, because this is my question, is I went to Thailand with Dr. Templeman and the owners of the company on a trip that you can go on too, because XANGO's has all kinds of amazing trips that we can win and we can experience. This was my first one. And I went to Thailand and I got to eat fresh mangosteen fruit every single day, stayed at the mangosteen resort. And so they had baskets full of fresh mangosteen just sitting right on the front desk. And every day I went and grabbed plenty of it and took it back to my room. Well, you are not allowed to take this out of the country. However, I've never been a rule follower, so which is why I'm an entrepreneur. But I brought this back. Now, I thought I was going to have to bring this fruit back, and I was going to have to preserve it, right? I was going to have to shellac it or whatever, and I was going to learn how and Google how to preserve the fruit, because obviously fruit will rot. And, of course, I never got around to it. And this basket full of mangosteen never rotted. Now, I was told it's because one of the benefits of the mangosteen fruit is it's an antifungal. Just thought of this recently. But can you tell us why this fruit is all still perfect? It just dried out. There's no mold. There's no fungus. There's no anything. And now that we're drinking it, is that how it affects our bodies? It keeps the, I mean, it helps us with not getting mold and fungus and stuff like that. But can you just tell us why this fruit, I did nothing to it.
No.
It's still good, and how that translates into the health benefits.
Well, first of all, the skin is very tough, even when it's not mummified. It's very, very tough, and nothing penetrates through, and it's very hard to sort of harm it. And therefore, there isn't a portal of entry for the kinds of things to get past its own barriers. This is the skin of the mangosteen, and that's why our skin is here, to keep the bad on the outside and the good on the good inside. And so all that's left is the water. Everything else is still here. There's some degeneration of the enzymes, but the fact of the matter is that all of the xanthones are there, all of the proanthocyanidins are there, all of the catechins are there. They're still in the fruit.
Could you rehydrate it?
Theoretically, you probably could. I don't know what it would taste like because it tasted crappy when it was fresh.
The skin did. The rind did. Yeah, the fruit tasted good.
The fruit is good. But yeah, that's the reason. And that's something that's quite remarkable because I don't imagine that there are very many fruits that if you did take them and leave them for 13 years would look very much like they did when you put them in the basket 13 years.
What about the grape?
Well, the grape would become a raisin.
Yeah, that's just it. It kind of burns out.
In fact, it tastes different because there's a concentration of the sugars, the polysaccharides, and the other things in there. And most of the nutrients are there. Yeah, we don't want to age like a grape. We want to age like a
okay. Okay, so we'll take just a couple of questions if anybody has any questions for Dr. Templeman. And if not, we can just mix and mingle after, but I thought ones that everybody might want to hear. Yes, Jeanette?
So I know the whole air system is good to work together, but if you don't really have wrinkles right now and you have problems with the dark circles, which one is best to use?
The gel or the complex? Remember, the gel is largely cosmetic. It's there for people with wrinkles to get their wrinkles gone temporarily. The wrinkles come back to some degree lessened by the fact that they've been stretched out and that something's working in the under structure. But the fact of the matter is that that gel is largely to spread the skin and get the wrinkles gone temporarily to go up. The dark circles are only going to be helped by the complex itself. So if what you're looking to do is change the discoloration that may be under your eyes, that's what you want to use, is the compounds. Yes?
Well, this is more like, was it my aunt? I was telling my aunt about it, and she said she was using Miriam before, like, a long time ago. Mm-hmm. And then she started to get, like, little, like, grease balls on, like, inside her skin.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what they're called, but... And then she stopped using it.
Uh-huh.
And then again, she started using it a month ago.
Uh-huh.
She got it again.
Remember that the best advice you can give somebody regarding a supplement is try it, see what it does for you. Okay? The responses that individuals have are very, very individual. But I imagine she's going to stop it again because she had an adverse reaction. And I would suggest that if anybody has an adverse reaction to these products, that they stop them. But let me tell you something. There have been millions and billions of servings of the juice in the United States for the last 10 years, not for the full 13 years of the company. I have been the medical officer to whom any adverse reaction has to be reported through me, and they pay me money to do that. And guess what? I haven't had to do report one in 10 years. There hasn't been an adverse reaction that has taken someone to a doctor or to a hospital or to some place where there would be danger to their health as a result of that. That, for me, is an endorsement. And this is a drink that people use on all kinds of medications and not a single food-drug interaction that has ever caused anybody any harm. So do I feel comfortable in saying, try it? Regardless of your circumstances, try it and see what happens. I don't feel like I'm inviting anybody into disaster by doing that. Okay? Question?
Is it the anti-inflammatory properties of the juice that helps people with arthritis?
It is my belief that it is the anti-inflammatory properties of the juice that help most people. Let me give you an example of inflammation-based diseases. Now, there's a disclaimer. The kind of evidence that would allow me to say, this will help you if you have this, does not exist. Those are human randomized. Nobody's going to pay to do those, and so therefore nobody will be able to say, try this and it will do this. That's not what you can say. You can only say, try and see what happens to you. But here are the list of a few of the inflammatory-based diseases. Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, other forms of dementia, depression, ADHD, these are the autistic syndrome. All of these are conditions in which the brain is inflamed. Okay, let's go to something else. Cardiovascular disease that causes strokes and that causes the accumulation of plaque in arteries. Absolutely an inflammatory disease, not a disease of cholesterol principally. Gastrointestinal problems, Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, gastritis, ulcers, regurgitation, all of them based in inflammation. And cancer, a great deal of this is based in inflammation. The beginning of cancer, the progress of cancer and the eventual spreading of cancer to other organs than where it first happened. Basically, that's an inflammatory process. So if you can take something safe daily that has the effect of making the inflammation in your body better, why wouldn't you benefit? Okay? Yes.
Is the collagen safe to take twice a day?
Absolutely. I don't pay for my products, I use it twice a day.
You're
being a good one when
you say that.
Well, that's one of the perks that I. And that's about all I can do is sort of say, you can trust it. Now, try it.
Awesome. Okay, well, thank you very much. If you have any other questions, they can ask them one-on-one, and we'll say goodbye to our audience. And we are going to put the slides to this video so that we'll make it available so you can see, because I know you really can't see what's on the TV there. And thanks to all of you for hanging out with us this late. We do have a lot of snacks and stuff in the back. And thank you so much for being here. And for those of you who brought guests, you guys get boxes of Limitless. Your guests got the best day yet. You get boxes of Limitless. And for those of you who have not tried the collagen drink, we made some over there. So there's some samples. So please get yourself a sample of the collagen. And those of you who would like to try the eye gel, get with the person who invited you here. We'll sneak off in a little corner and get a before picture, let you try it, and get an after, and let you see for yourself how amazing this product line is. Yeah. So thank you all for coming.